Hey everybody, it's me, Timmy Flyersguys, and I wanted to come on here and tell you about my show on my YouTube channel, and that show is the Timmy Flyersguys Podcast. The Timmy Flyersguys Podcast is a weekly podcast that airs every Monday on the Timmy Flyersguys YouTube channel. The Timmy Flyersguys Podcast. It's not just about Flyers hockey, it's about many other things as well. A lot of things that I am passionate about, and a lot of things that inspire me. So if you're looking for a great podcast, then I suggest you check out the Timmy Flyersguys Podcast, airing every Monday on the Timmy Flyersguys YouTube channel. So make sure you check out the Timmy Flyersguys Podcast. Sometimes I'll have a guest on my podcast as well. So make sure you check out the Timmy Flyersguys Podcast on the Timmy Flyersguys YouTube channel. It's a lot of fun, and you'll have a great time. Hey everybody, it's me, Timmy Flyersguy, and welcome to the Flyersguys Top 10. On this week's episode, I'm gonna do a Top 10 favorite shows that I watched when I was a kid. Yes, I've done the Netflix Top 10 video, and today I'm gonna do the Top 10 shows. My top 10 favorite shows that I watched as a kid. So I hope you guys enjoy this walk down memory lane of some of the shows that I used to watch as a kid. So let's start the episode and let's get ready for my top 10 favorite TV shows I used to watch as a kid. My number 10 pick, Rugrats. I remember the first time this show premiered on Nickelodeon. It was one of the first Nicktoons for Nickelodeon. It premiered in August of 1991. Rugrats is the story of babies, Tommy, Chucky, Phil, Lil, and the toddler, Angelica, who is Tommy's cousin. Rugrats is a weird show. It's a very weird show. About these babies who have very overactive imaginations, and they go on some crazy adventures. This was one of my favorite TV shows that I watch every morning on Nickelodeon when it used to be shown on Nickelodeon. Even now, it is now shown on Paramount Plus. We can find all the Rugrats episodes. Over the years, Rugrats expanded its characters. In later years, 2000, character Kimmy, Chucky's adopted sister, Chucky's stepsister, who came into the picture when Jazz, Chucky's dad, married Kimmy's mother in the movie Rugrats in Paris. Kimmy was a character added to Rugrats. And then back in 98, Baby Dill was introduced in the first movie, the Rugrats movie. A lot of expansions to the series went Years later, in the summer of 2001, the pilot episode of All Grew Up was shown. The show was so popular that a year after, in 2003, All Grown Up premiered on Nickelodeon. And it wasn't as good as the original Rugrats. A couple years ago, a reboot of Rugrats was made on Paramount Plus. It's a claymation version of the show Rugrats. So I really enjoyed this show as a kid. It was a real fun show. It had some comedy. It had some good stories. And hell, who knew a show about a bunch of babies would be so popular? Okay. Our number 10 pick. The Nickelodeon version of Doug. This show also premiered in 1991 on Nickelodeon. Doug is the story of a preteen boy named Doug Funny who moves to Bluffington from Bloatsburg with his family. His sister Judy, his dad Phil, and his mom Vita. And he also has a dog named Porkchop, who's really smart. Doug is the story of a preteen boy named Doug, just trying to live his life. The great thing about Doug is he has a very overactive imagination. And he constantly writes in his journal about how his day is going and how life is going. He is in love with the character Patty Mayonnaise. He also has to deal with the bully, Roger Klotz. But he also has some great adventures with his best friend Skeeter and many other friends of his, such as B.B. Bluff, Connie Binge, and many other great characters. I really enjoyed Doug, because it really showed you what life is like as a teenager. And it really explored how overactive Doug's imagination is. He also has an alter ego named Quail Man. And also an alter ego, Smash Adams, Race County, and many others. Doug is a great show. It is now streaming on Paramount Plus. So make sure you check it out. I really enjoyed this show. One of my favorite cartoons. As a kid, one of my favorite Nicktoons. One of the OG Nicktoons of the Nickelodeon era. At number 8, the Disney's version of Doug. Many people don't really like this show. Many people were outraged when Disney bought Doug from Nickelodeon and changed everything around. Basically the characters, and basically their voices. But to tell you the truth, this show isn't really that bad. I first started watching Disney's Doug back in September of 1998. I really enjoyed it. I actually watched it before in December of 1996. First episode I watched was the Christmas episode. Disney's Doug is the same story. Doug's a little older now, and a lot of things have changed. He goes to a new school. Everything's changed for his friends. But I really like Disney's Doug, because, you know, this show really had some good messages. Really, you know, it had some good morals as well. Really enjoyed Disney's Doug. Disney's Doug really gets a bad rap from some people, but to me, I thought it was a great show. And I enjoyed watching it every morning back in 1998. And I gotta tell you, I started rewatching these shows as well. You can find Disney's Doug on Disney Plus. So make sure you check it out. It's really not as bad as people say it is. So I think you should check it out. At number 7, And now we get to number 7. Number 7, The Simpsons. An all-time favorite show. I grew up watching as a kid, and I still occasionally watch, sometimes. All the old episodes. Simpsons is a show about a family living in the town of Springfield. A very dysfunctional family. With the son, Bart Simpson, the daughter, Lisa Simpson, the wife, Marge Simpson, the dad, Homer Simpson, the baby, Maggie Simpson, the dog, Santa's little helper, and the cat, Snowball, too. The Simpsons was a show created by Matt Groening in 1989. The first episode premiered in December of 1989, and it was the Christmas episode of The Simpsons. I first started watching The Simpsons back in the summer of 94. First episode I saw was the episode where Bart gets an elephant. Now let's get into the synopsis. The Simpsons is a great show, and there are some great episodes. Some episodes really tug at our heartstrings, and some episodes that really make us laugh. The Simpsons is a very iconic TV show, and it's one of my many favorite TV shows. I have the DVDs somewhere in my house, and you can also watch The Simpsons on Disney Plus. The Simpsons was one of my all-time favorites, and one of the best shows that I've ever watched. I've never seen a show that can make me laugh as much as The Simpsons. So if you're a fan of the show, I suggest you check it out. It's on Disney Plus. It's The Simpsons. At number six. John Callahan's Pelswick. Pelswick is a show about a young boy, a young preteen boy, who happens to be in a wheelchair. Pelswick was a very underrated show. The show Pelswick started on Nickelodeon in 2000. It ran from 2000 to 2002 on Nickelodeon. The story of Pelswick is he's a kid in a wheelchair, but he doesn't let that bother him. The kid in a wheelchair who has some crazy adventures. He has a crazy family and a crazy grandma, but she means well. Pelswick is such a great show. It teaches us that sometimes when you're disabled, you just gotta be happy. There are some episodes that really speak to us, especially the episode where Pelswick is getting bullied for being in a wheelchair. I myself know what that's like, as I've gotten bullied too. But people learn, and people grow out of their bullying stages, and they realize that people in wheelchairs are people too. John Callahan was the creator of Pelswick. He was a man who was paralyzed in a car accident. And Pelswick and this inspired him to write a show about a kid in a wheelchair named Pelswick. It's, it sucks this show only lasted for 2 seasons, but it was a very good show and I really enjoyed it. At number 5, Hey Arnold. Hey Arnold is a very good show. Set in New York City, the story of a football-headed boy named Arnold who lives with his grandparents in a boarding house. This show is a really underrated show. A lot of people like it, a lot of people don't like it. But honestly, I really enjoyed this show. teaches us about a lot of great life lessons. And a lot of lessons about being a good person. And being, show us a lot of great morals in it. And a lot of episodes are very true to life. So if you haven't checked out Hey Arnold yet, I suggest you check it out. It's on Disney Plus. It's on Paramount Plus. And you can stream it anytime. Well, I'm going to take a quick break, and we'll get to our last picks after this commercial break, so stay tuned. Hey everybody, it's me, Timmy Flyersguys, and I have a new show, exclusively on my Instagram, Timmy the Flyersguy, 215, and exclusively in the Flyers Extreme Facebook group. And that show is the Orange and Black Recap. The Orange and Black Recap recaps every single end to a Philadelphia Flyers game with me, Timmy Flyersguy. So check out the Orange and Black Recap on my Instagram, Timmy the Flyersguy 215, and also on the Flyers Extreme Facebook group. I'm Timmy Flyersguy, and I hope you enjoy my new show exclusively on my Instagram and exclusively on the Flyers Extreme Facebook group. Let's go Flyers! Tell me more. Let's get in more about Hey Arnold. Hey Arnold is such a great show. There are so many layers to the show, and so many great stories, and so many great episodes. So I suggest you check out Hey Arnold. You could stream Hey Arnold on Paramount Plus. It's a great show, one of my favorite all-time Netflix. At number 4. And by the way, you can also find Pelswick. You can find season 1, season 2 episodes on YouTube. I'll check that out. Alright, at my number 4 pick, The Adventures of Pete and Pete. A show created in 1992 on SNICK and Nickelodeon. The Adventures of Pete and Pete started out as shorts on Nickelodeon, or short episodes on Nickelodeon, as basically pilot episodes for the eventual series. Creator of Pete and Pete wanted to do a show about a dog, the boy and his dog. That show was quickly dropped, and he decided to do a show about two boys named Pete and Pete. Older Pete and younger Pete. Pete and Pete is a story of Big Pete and Little Pete. Pete and Pete is a very complex show. And it kind of has a Seinfeld-esque look at life. It's one of my favorite TV shows that I started getting to watch again. I have season 1 to season 2 on DVD. Season 3, DVD was discontinued. And they would not sell it. Adventure of Pete and Pete starts out like this. We got the character Little Pete, who has some outrageous adventures with his best friend Artie, the strongest man in the world. And we also have Big Pete, who constantly has a crush on Ellen Hickle, but they're actually really just friends. I really like this show. It's one of my favorite shows. There are some great episodes of the show. King of the Road was a good episode. Day of the Dot was okay. But, you know, there were some great episodes. I really enjoyed some of them. And they tackle a lot of strange problems. Like, why do we have to multiply X? What is so important about that? And also, it also deals with some sibling rivalry as well. But, otherwise, this is a great, great series. I really enjoyed it. The music in the show is great. Polaris does the intro for PMP. A lot of great underrated groups such as Polaris by Magic Fields, The Sixth, and many other great bands as well. So if you haven't checked it out yet, check out the Adventures of Pete and Pete. You can't stream the show anywhere, but you can find episodes from all three seasons on YouTube. And now we get to our third pick, Rocko's Modern Life, another one of my favorite shows. The show that premiered on Nickelodeon in 1993. Rocko's Modern Life is a story about a wallaby named Rocko, his dog Spunky, his best friend Heifer, the steer, and his best friend Filbert, the turtle. Rocko's Modern Life is a very wacky, outrageous cartoon show. I really enjoyed it, and there's a lot of adult themes that'll go over kids' heads. When I was a kid, I really didn't understand the adult themes. But once I got older, started watching Rocko's Modern Life again, I started to understand that this show may not be for children. But to tell you the truth, this show is one of the most hilarious shows I've ever watched. So if you haven't watched Rocko's Modern Life, check it out. You stream Rocko's Modern Life on Paramount Plus. Alright, we get to our final picks of this episode. Number two. A very underrated Saban show. VR Troopers. VR Troopers was created in 1994 during the second season of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. VR Troopers has many similarities to the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. They transform and they have a lot of cool gadgets. VR Troopers is a story about Ryan Steele, Caitlin Starr, and J.B. Reese. Ryan Steele is a martial artist. He's trying to just find out the whereabouts of his missing father. Caitlin Starr is a reporter. And J.B. Reese is the Billy of the show. He's the one who is a technical genius in the show. VR Troopers is a show about three teenagers, Ryan Steele, Caitlin Starr, and J.B. Reese, protecting the world from the evil Grimlord. An evil mutant from another planet that creates evil robots to destroy the world. The show is set in the fictional world of Crossworld City. VR Troopers is one of my favorite shows. I really enjoyed it. I used to watch it every day when it came on Philly 57. And it's a great show and a great Saban show. It only lasted for two seasons, but it was one of my favorites. I think you can still stream VR Troopers on Netflix. I'm not sure. I think you can still stream it on Netflix, I think. But if you can find VR Troopers, I suggest you watch it. It's a great show. And now we get to our final pick. A show that really revamped my childhood. And that is The Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. Created by Saban in September 93. The Mighty Morphin Power Rangers is about 6 to 5 teenagers. Actually, 6 teenagers. But it starts out as 5 teenagers summoned by Zordon to protect the world from the evil Rita Repulsa. It's one of my favorite shows. It has a lot of martial arts action, a lot of great action, and a lot of cool giant robot scenes. Power Rangers is an adaptation of a Japanese show called Chiyo Sentai Z-Ranger in Japan. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers lasted from 1993 to 1996. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers was one of my favorite shows. And it also introduced one of the newest Power Rangers, the Green Ranger Tommy, the Green Power Ranger, wrote his own miniseries called Green with Evil, which is one of my favorite Power Rangers miniseries. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers is one of the best Power Rangers series Saban has ever made, and I absolutely enjoyed every moment of these episodes. Power Rangers is a great show, and it really was a big part of my childhood. And I owe it to Power Rangers for making my childhood awesome. So if you haven't checked out Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, what are you waiting for? Check it out on Netflix. You can stream it on Netflix. It's a great show and one of my favorites. Well, that's it for my top 10 shows I watched when I was a kid. I hope you all enjoyed this episode, and I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I hope you guys are enjoying my series. If you guys have any ideas for a top 10 list, please leave. If you have any ideas for the next episode, please leave a comment in the description below. Thank you for joining me, and this has been the latest episode of the Flyersguys Top 10. Thank you for joining me, and have a great day, everyone.